So, ladies and gentlemen, I propose we start with this meeting now. It's a great pleasure for me to open this event, which is a special event which we are organizing in cooperation with the Konstantinos Karamanlis Foundation. And, of course, it's in the honor of the 10th anniversary of the passing of Konstantinos Karamanlis. And it is for SEPS a special occasion to honor one of the fathers of the European movement, of the European idea, and of course also of the concrete achievements of the European Union, because that is what we see today of a vague idea which started a long time ago and which was perceived by some people already quite clearly quite early. And a very small number of people started to work on it to make it become a reality. And Konstantinos Karamanlis was one of them. And the purpose of the day today is to reflect on his ideas and, of course, on where we are today in practical terms, in the institutions that we have, and where do we go from here? How can we develop these ideas? How can we make Europe, how can we make the European Union stronger? Can we make the European Union a global actor? Can we make more of what, so to speak, the fathers have left us as of today? And as we will hear later, I presume the current economic crisis is a good occasion to sharpen our mind and focus our attention on what to do right now. Now, with this, I would like just to finish my own introduction because, of course, today the place of honor belongs to the memory of Konstantinos Karamanlis. And that's why now I would like to invite the Professor Konstantinos Volopoulos, who will... we have a member of the Greek Parliament here and also the Vice Chairman of the Karamanlis Foundation, Achilles Karamanlis, who will now have a brief introductory remark himself. And then later we have a presentation of the ideas and of the memory of the legacy of Konstantinos Karamanlis.
Ladies and gentlemen, dear friends, on behalf of the Konstantin Karamanlis Foundation, I am happy to address today's international meeting on the occasion of the 10th anniversary of the passing of Konstantin Karamanlis. The Greek leader was worked determined much of the history of my country. My feeling has to do with the high level of our meeting. Thanks to the participation of the Center for European Policy Studies and the timely topic chosen on the past and the future of the United Europe. Thus, the participation of our foundation in the organization of the present meeting is an unfortunate occasion, especially if one considers that it bears the name of Konstantin Karamanlis, who himself was not only a protagonist in the age of the birth of European unification, but he led in the peaceful vocation of his nation within all the peoples of Europe and in the promotion of the European idea. Konstantin Karamanlis set three major goals for his policy: the economic development of Greece, the consolidation of Greek democracy, and Greece's participation in the making of new Europe. This first goal was achieved early on during his first tenure in power between 1955-1963. The second was completed with his return from Paris and the impeccable functioning of democracy in Greece after 1974. The third goal was his constant care from the time of creation of the common market, which enhanced the expectation for a European Union, and at the end of his life, more that of 40 years later. From the very start, already in 1958, he planned and then submitted the application, conducted the negotiations, and signed the deal for the Association of Greece in 1961, and then for the accession to the European Community some 20 years later. His devotion to the European idea was strong, and he defended this consistently throughout the post-war period. He tried strengthening his foundation by identifying its cultural and political roots. He claimed that the European civilization is a synthesis of the Greek, the Roman, and the Christian spirit. The Greek spirit contributed the ideas of freedom, truth, and the duty. The Roman, those of the state and the law, and the Christian, those of the birth and love. Today, 10 years after the passing of Constantine Karamanlis, when the principles who defined the policy of those leaders who founded the new Europe, including Karamanlis himself, are being tested, it is useful to return to the motives and the ideas who inspired them all. This short reference justifies the participation of the present meeting of Constantine Karamanlis Foundation, a foundation put together by Karamanlis himself in order that the historical record is preserved and the guiding principles he served are promoted. The establishment of the foundation in 1983 was a pioneering act in our country. Constantine Karamanlis wished to highlight his work after World War II, and he deposited his personal archive in full to the benefit of the scholars of the contemporary history. I would like to thank the board and the people of SHEPS, and in particular its director Daniel Cross, for the exceptional cooperation we have had. The speakers, academicians, and politicians alike, who kindly accepted our invitation, and all are for being here today. In our troubled times, the idea for a political union can surely lead the way for the benefit of the people of Europe and world peace, as Karamanlis strongly believed. Thank you very much.